So let's begin with the 21st question in this very third part of the November 4th week Prelims Mastery episode. So which of the following statements are true about the Business Advisory Committee of the Parliament? The first statement says a Business Advisory Committee regulates the program and timetable of the Parliament. Second one says a bill can be introduced only after bringing it to the notice of the committee. So which one of these is right? Let's check that. It says only first statement is right. Business Advisory Committee regulate the program and timetable of the Parliament. This is the right statement. However, there is no compulsion that bill has to be introduced into the Parliament only after it is brought to the notice of the Business Advisory Committee. There is no rule as such, because recently this very committee was in news because the J&K bifurcation bill was directly introduced in Lok Sabha without bringing it to the notice of Business Advisory Committee, and many MPs of the opposition party were not okay with that. Okay, so please understand what is Business Advisory Committee and what are its limitations. So let's go to the next one. 22nd, recently seen in news, Pegasus is a, what is this? Is it A, first artificial intelligent robot built by India, a military exercise, it's a spyware, next generation quantum computing device? So what is this Pegasus? So the answer is, it's a spyware. Yes, it's a spyware which was made by an Israeli company, okay, called NSO, and there was this accusation on government that government used this Pegasus spyware to spy on some of the human activists of India, and it was also accused that this very spyware was were infected into the very mobile phones of those human activists through WhatsApp video. Okay, so please remember this. The next one. Which of the following statements are correct? Supplementary demand for grants is stable during the annual budget. The second statement says the Public Accounts Committee examines the excess required and gives recommendations to the Parliament. So which of the following statements are correct? Is it what? Two, both, neither? Let's check. Two only. So how many of you got this one as the right one? I hope many of you. So it says the Public Accounts Committee examines the excess required and gives recommendations to the Parliament. This is the right one, right statement. However, supplementary demand for grants is tabled not during the annual budget. No, it is not during the annual budget. It is tabled when the government is short of funding here, short of finances. When it is short of finances, this very bill is actually introduced in the Parliament. Right now, this was introduced in Lok Sabha. Nirmala Sitaraman who was actually persuaded by Amit Shah, actually introduced this in Lok Sabha, because now we need some excess money to take care of new Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. So because of that, we wanted extra finance, extra money. Hence, supplementary demand for grants was introduced in the Lok Sabha. So please understand. The next one. Which of the following statements are true about P-81 aircraft? P-81 or P-81 aircraft? This was in news quite recently. So let's understand. The first statement. It is manufactured by United Air Corporation, Aircraft Corporation of Russia. It will be used by Indian Navy. It will be used for maritime surveillance, anti-submarine warfare and anti-surface vessel strike. So which of these statements are right? Let's understand. D, 2 and 3, that is second and third statements are right, whereas the first one is the wrong one. United Aircraft Corporations of Russia, they make aircraft such as Sukhoi. Okay, MiG, Sukhoi, all these are made by United Aircraft Corporation, whereas P-81, we are buying it from USA. And the company's name is Airbus. Alright, we are buying it from Airbus, which is a USA based company. And other two statements are right here. Okay, now this was in news recently because our defense agency is actually planning to procure P-81 aircraft from Airbus. Okay, so let's go to the next one. Which of the following acts are to be amalgamated through Industrial Relations Code Bill 2019? So which of the following acts? Now, some of the acts are amalgamated, are joined together to form only one single act or one single code. So which of these four are amalgamated? Let's understand. So is it the Trade Unions Act 1926, the Code on Wages 2005, the Industrial Employment Act of 1946, the Industrial Disputes Act of 1947? So check the options and think and see if you know the right answer. You might sometimes know that, right? So let's check for the right answer. It says 1, 3 and 4. Option, statement 1, 3 and 4. And the second one is the wrong one here. So this very Industrial Relations Code Bill 2019 is an amalgamation of the Trade Unions Act, the Industrial Employment Act and the Industrial Disputes Act. And it is not including the Code on Wages 2005 Act here. So the second one is the wrong one. So please remember this. Next one. Which of the following statements are incorrect? The first one, global migration reports are released by United Nations Development Program, UNDP. According to the report, India is the largest country of origin of international migrants. That means India is producing more number of migrants who are going from India to another country. So we are the largest immigrants. That's what it says. The third statement, China has received the maximum remittance this year. Maximum remittance. Okay. And the fourth option and the fourth statement says US is the top destination for migrants. So which of the following statements are correct and which of the options below are correct here? Let's check. D1 and 3 are incorrect. The question asks us to find out the incorrect statement. So 1 and 3 are incorrect, but however 2 and 4 are the correct statements. The first statement says global migration reports are released by UNDP. It is not UNDP. It is released by International Organization for Migration. It is a UN intergovernmental organization. So please remember this. Okay. And the third statement says China has received the maximum remittance this year. No, it is not China. India has received the maximum remittance followed by, China and Mexico. Okay, so let's go to the next one. Sagar Doctrine is what? An initiative for peace in Indian Ocean region. India's counter-terrorism strategy along sea borders. Coastal Economic Development Program, Cyclone and Tsunami Management Strategy. So which one of the options is right here? So what do you think? Let's check. So it's an initiative for peace in Indian Ocean region. So please understand, Sagar Mala is different and Sagar Doctrine is different. So the first option is right. This was first proclaimed by Pradhan Mantri Modi when he visited Mauritius. So he said that we have to safeguard our shores and hence he said that we have to have initiative for maintaining peace in the Indian Ocean region. Okay, next one. Gross fixed capital formation indicates. What does it indicate? Export of capital goods, import of capital goods, GDP after deducting taxes, D, investment. So what does gross fixed capital formation indicates? Now we see these kind of terms often in the newspaper, especially in the economy section. So what's the right answer? The right answer is D, investment. Okay. Now this was in news because of the GDP, issue. You know, the GDP fell to 4.5%. So at that time, this very thing was in news. So gross fixed capital formation indicates what amount of investment has been done in the market here. Okay. Is industry, whatever they are procuring as a profit, are they investing some of it into the market again? So this very term here indicates that. Okay. So let's go to the next one. Which of the following are correct about SAFAR system? S-A-F-A-R. It is developed by Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, Pune. It gives out a real-time traffic situation along with 72 hours advance forecast. It is introduced by the Ministry of Road Transport and Highway. So which of the following options are right here? Let's check. It says one only. The correct statement is the first statement and the other two are wrong. It gives out real-time traffic situation. No, not traffic situation. It gives out air pollution. In the third option, it is introduced by Ministry of Road Transport and Highway. No, It is by the Ministry of Earth Sciences. Please understand, not Ministry of Transport, but Ministry of Earth Sciences. Okay, let's go to the last question of this very fourth week November's MCQs, you know, Prelims Mastery. So which of the following statements are true? COP25 is scheduled to be held in Berlin. The second statement, emissions gap report is released by UNEP, that is United Nations Environment Program. So which one of the options here is the right one? Let's check. It says B, 2 only. That means only second one is right. Emissions gap report is released by United Nations Environment Program. However, COP25 is scheduled to be held in not Berlin, but in Madrid. Okay, so please understand, it is in Madrid. It is currently going right now. So I think you need to have watch on that. Okay, so with this, we complete this fourth week of November's Prelims Mastery. And in the next week, we'll come up with the first week of the December's thing. And I hope this was, very beneficial for you. It added value to your preparation. I want you guys to leave in the comment section as in how you felt. You know, do you want any more things to be added to these videos? Let me know about that. Okay, and I hope that you also leave out the comments as in how much did you score, you know, out of 10 in each of the parts. Okay, so with that, I wish you all the best, and we'll get back in the next week with some more MCQs about first week December's contemporary and current affairs through Prelims Mastery. Take care, all the best.